So, a very good morning to all of you here. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thanks for your response here. So, let us continue our previous discussion here. In the previous few classes, we explored about the multiple random variables here, and subsequent to the multiple random variables discussion here, we have converges to the two random variables here, which was just next extension of the one random variable concepts here. So in case of two random variables here, we are moving ahead in the two random variables. In the previous few discussion here, if you remember, we talk about their probability distribution, what we talk about the probability distribution function, probability density function here, and moreover, we also explore a few of the characteristic or even the property of the two random variables in terms of their conditional probability functions here, as well as the marginal probability density functions here. Okay, so can anyone differentiate the conditional probability density function and the marginal probability density function? Can anyone differentiate between the conditional probability density function and the marginal density functions here? No one? This is a surprise. You will just forget everything, whatever you have discussed. This is very surprising here. Okay, so let me revise to you here, and then we'll come to the today's discussion here. So if you remember, when you talk about the probability density function, the distribution function here, and then in the extension we explore in case of conditional probability density functions here. When you talk about the conditional probability density function here with respect to the two random variables here, x and y here, I think someone needs to mute himself here. This is Divyash Kuswaha from Ishi. Okay. So, when you talk about the conditions here, then with respect to the two random variables, the information about the one random variable is already known to me here. And then with respect to the that information, we are trying to find out what could be the outcome here. For example, at the transmitter end, we have transmitted the bit 0 here, and we are speculating that the receiver end, the received bit will be 0 or 1 here. Okay. So this could be one kind of an answer. Other could be at the receiver end, we have received the bit 0, and we are trying to find out the transmitted bit was 0 or the transmitted bit was 1 here. So this kinds of information or prediction we could perform with the help of conditional density functions here. And subsequently, we have also discovered the marginal here. So in case of marginal here, if you remember here, the marginal density function we find out from the joint density functions here. In case of joint density functions here, if you're talking about x here, then with respect to that, y is known to me here. Here, and if you're talking about the marginal density function for y here, then x will be known here. So in this way, we have done this exercise in case of marginal here. Okay. So now we are moving ahead with few more terms here. Without going into much detail, we will come to our discussion of agendas here. And the point is covariance and the correlations here, which we are going to discuss here. So the correlation between random variable x and y denoted as here rho xy here. Rho xy will be the covariance x and y divided by root bx bi to sigma xy divided by sigma x and sigma y here. So for any two random variable x and y, this value is going to be in the range of minus 1 to 1 here. So there's a few of the property you should remember. So for discrete random variable x and y with joint distributions here, we could find out their associated joint distribution functions here, or you can say their joint covariance or the correlation here. So this is distribution for x and y here. So for the combined functions here, based on the information we have to give it, so x-axis, you can see there are some value of x, because you can say x is equal to 1, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 2. We have some information, x is equal to 3. We also have the information here. And similarly, for y is equal to 0, 1, 2, and 3. It is associated with some few more values here. So we have some ideas here based on observing this density function here. And we will go for the calculation as desired here. So first we will go for the calculation of expectation functions here. You can say joint expectation functions or individual here, then we could calculate here. Then once we have calculated these things here, then we will go for the variance properties here. So in the previous class here, if you remember, we have calculated the variance. So corresponding to the value x, and it is x bar here. This is mu. Mu. The formula, it is mu here. So mu is nothing but the expectation operation on the variable x here. Here, this is precisely, we could say this is mu x here. So this is value of x minus mu x bar. Mu x here, this is corresponding to 1 minus mu square here. So this is the value of mu we are substituting here, and we are going here. But if you remember, in case of x, we'll go for this one variable, x into fx. In case of variance, it is x square into fx here. So this x square, in case of variance, it is x minus x bar square into x here. So this way, we could just simply substitute the values. We will get the x, y, ex, and vx values here. Once we have the information about these individual terms here, now we will thought to move for the sigma xy here. Sigma xy we could calculate here, and the correlation here, exy minus ex into ey. So just simply substitute the values in this function here, and we can calculate the final values here. Furthermore, if you go for the second terms here, that is the correlation here, the covariance here, then rho xy, substitute the values. Simply, what is calculated here? This one. Why we are going for the similar fashion here? Because if you see this graph here, this graph is symmetrical. Distribution of the values are symmetrical with respect to the x and y here. That's why the value is going to be same here. That's why you can observe this value of sigma x into sigma y. Both places we are going to the root 1.36 here. Okay, so the symmetry here we apply the here. So out of that, another we could find out. But if you want here, we can go for the similar operation here. Just like mu x we find out, we can go for mu y functions here in this similar manner, just like. Okay, so if x and y are independent number variables here, so these are the general terms which we use here, find out the correlation between the variables here. If you remember, when you talk about the independent properties here, then the two random variables are totally independent here, means they are not having any kind of relation with respect to each other here, or any dependency among them here, or the occurrence of any one event is going to be associated with the occurrence of another events here. So these are totally independent events here. For example, if you remember, if I'm going to toss a coin here, I'm going to toss a coin first time, then head or tail appear here. If I'm going to toss a coin second time here, so the head or tail will have the same values, and it is totally independent of the values which appear in the first time. Okay, but if we consider there is a card here, or you can say there is a pool here, there on that pool there are 10 balls here. So out of the 10 balls, if I have drawn one ball here, so what is the probability here with that ball? If I not replace that ball here with another same color ball here, then if I'm going to draw a second ball here, then the probability is highly dependent here, because what we have drawn here, based on that, will change here. If I be more specific here, so I could say, suppose out of the 10 balls here, then our red balls are 4 here, and white balls are 6 here. So there is a pool, 10 balls comprises here. If I'm going to draw a ball here first, what is the probability that it is red here? So it will be 4 by 10. Okay. But if I'm going to perform the same operation next time here, if I have not replaced the ball here, then it will be, the total number will be reduced from 10 to the 9, and the red balls will be also reduced from the 4 to the 3 here. So it will be 3 by 9 here. So this kind of dependency is not present here. So they are, when you say the independent here, then they are, then the occurrence of one random variables, or the occurrence of event is totally different with respect to the occurrence of other events here. Okay, or again, the random variables X is totally independent with respect to the random variables Y here. So there are these function, the density, distribution functions, all are totally independent, and they are segregable here. So each level I could segregate X and Y with respect to the each others here from the given functions here. So in case of covariance here, we have just used this formula here. Covariance is xy is equal to ax minus a into y minus ey here. And what we have written, this is exy minus ex into ey here. Correct? Can anyone prove it? Can anyone prove it? So if anyone has completed, then he just simply switch on his video and demonstrate it, or you can suggest it in the chat box here, or you can speak up. So all the three options are open to you. How we are reaching from here to here? Anyone can? Okay, take your time, just take 2 minutes and tell me the solution.
So you could just expand all the things that are in the E part, and you will get two terms like xy minus x ey minus e xy plus ex ey, and we know that the ey is a constant value, so we can just take it out, then we will get, if we like write it down individually, then we will get e xy. And what will happen to minus e minus x ey is that ey will be taken out, and it will be converted into ey into ex, and that's the same. Correct. Will be same will happen to minus ex multiplied by y, that will ex will be taken out, and it will be minus ex multiplied by ey, and the last term is ex multiplied by ey, that is a constant, and we know the e of constant is 1. So the both will be taken out and it will be multiplied to 1. So we will get 4 terms, exy, and minus 2 times ex dot ey, and one last term will be plus ex dot ey, and that would cancel and give it this.
Correct. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very nicely you explained it here. So whatever you said here, we need to just simply expand it here. So if you remember, when you're going for this process here, so the hint was just in front of you here. So here we are going to perform the expectation operation on x minus ex into y minus ey here. Okay. So just this here. So simply you should write it here. First here, what will the product are inside here? Take the multiplication of this product here. So multiplication will give you these terms here. And out on top of these terms here, we have to perform the expectation operations here. Okay. So here, when it's a perform the expectation operation, one by one, you can move off in here. So out of these two, you can observe here. For example, if you go expectation on this way, this is already expectation operations here. This will be constant here, values here. So this expectation operation will be applicable on this x only here. This ey terms could be taken out from this expectation operation here. Similar argument we can put forth here for the second terms here. In the second terms, ex will be taken out here. Here and this expectation operation will be on this y terms here. So ey will appear here. And in case of expectation, ex and ey both are constant here. So this term will remain same here, unchanged here. So now you have all the four terms here. Here after the expectation operation, if you look at the terms here, then few terms will cancel out here. And after the cancellation, finally you will get this terms here. Okay. I think Divyansh Kuswaha, you need to unmute yourself here. So continuously a noise is coming from your side here. So if anyone knows to him here, so you can just communicate the message to him. He need to unmute. Okay, so based on that, we could solve it here. That's why in the previous operation here, we have used this formulas here. Now we are taking one more example here. So random variables with zero covariance from example. The previous case, if you have observed here, we are moving ahead with the discrete functions here, where the value of x and y were discrete here. Now we have the continuous distribution of x and y here within this range here. Okay. Then the density function is given to us here. X, y is equal to 1 by 16 into x, y here. Okay. So if this information is known to us here, then we can find out what would be the expectation operations here. So in case of expectation operation, what we used to do here, in case of single variable here, we perform integration x into fx here. So as we are moving for the two random variables here, so this will be xy into fxy, xy into here. So means xy into joint density functions, and then it will be integrated by the double integrations here. In the previous one random variable, we are performing this operation with the single here. So in case of joint here, this will be double integration. This is joint density functions here, so it will have the two terms here, dx and dy both here. Now simply put the values here in this case. Once you substitute the values here, finally it will be like this here. So out of these terms here, we can solve it first and then substitute the values here. Then again, going for integration for the other terms here, then we will get to conclude here at last terms here. 1 by 6, 64 by 3. If I solve it here, it will come to 32 by 9 here. This will be final answer here. Okay. So this way we could solve it here. Okay. So if someone asked here, what about the individual here? We have gone for joint here because this joint density function was given to us here. So from the joint density function, we have applied the operation here, expectation operation on this joint terms here. But could we calculate the single terms here? ex, can we calculate? Can we calculate? Yes or no? Yes, at least your response is yes, very good. Yes, we can do here. And how can you calculate and tell me the values? So just solve it, this function solve it and tell me the value. Just giving a 2 minutes time here. Take the 2 minutes, solve it, and let me know what is the EX and EY. In the previous class here, we have discussed how we could find out the individual function values here from the joint density functions here. EX is equal to 4 by 3. Yes, correct. No, no, I think somewhere mistake here. Vikalp, I think calculation mistake you have done. So cross check it again. Anyone else has solved it here? Okay, anyone? I think you have taken 2 minutes time here, since this time is already over here. You need to be quick. Yes, we got the correct answer first here. Sandesh Kumar is given. Okay. So EX value is 4 by 3 and EY value is 8 by 3 here. So very correct here. So let's see the process here, how it is coming. So Sandesh, could you explain here to your colleagues here? Okay, anyway, no issue, no issue. That's optional here. So you have done what is desired here from your side. Okay, let me explain here for you. as the joint density function was given to us here, so from the joint density function, our objective was to go for the marginal density functions values here. So we could find out very easily here. So x here, what is the x into fxy here? X into what is the joint density functions here? What we have discussed here in our earlier discussion here, just simply here we have put the values here and we moved on here. Okay, so x into fxy, xy into dx dy. So simply, so what is the joint density function value fxy? It's already known to us here, so we can substitute it. Okay, here. So once you substitute it here, then we'll go for solving the functions here. So once you solve it here, this is a mistake. This is 1 by 16, x by 3 into 2 by 0 here. So range here you need to decide for the function 0 to 2 and 0 to 4 as given in the previous slides here. So you can pick the range from there here, and you can substitute it here. X square value will be x cube by 3 here. Substitute the values here, and then here I think there's y we are missing here, typo. So there will be y2 here because this is 1 by 16 xy here. So y you've taken here, so x is multiplication, so it will be x square, but y will say remains here. If you integrate and difference integrate y in dy here, so y dy will be y square by 2. And if you substitute the range value 0 to 4 here, so it will at this place here. So finally, it will be 1 by 16, 16 by 2. And if you solve it here, then you will get finally 4 by 3 values here. Okay. So, how many of you have got this answer here? You can respond in chat box, just a yes. I will have. I think two, three only here. So this simple integration here. Yes, okay. A few more have obtained this answer here for the EX. Good. So Vinayak, Nishok. Okay, Devansu done some calculation mistake. Dhaval got it. Good. Vikal done some calculation error here. Okay. So Sridhar, good. Okay. At least few of you have tried here, then you should know where you have done a mistake here. So next time when you'll go for it here, you will not commit such kinds of mistake here. Okay. So that's why I am giving this time to all here. Still little bit difficult to manage here, but okay, anyway. We have to come out these foundations here, and we have to try to do what could be the best one. Okay, so similar way we could explore for the EY function here, this margin density function for the random variable y, and in case of this one, double integration and y into fxy xy dx dy here. So we could substitute the values here. Here, so 1 by 16, that's will be taken out here as a constant here. So y in case of y square, this y is here, and from the density function xy here. So y into y square, and this again integration x here 0 to x into dx into dy here. So as we have done in the previous case here, first we operate on the x here, then move on y here. So we can go ahead in the similar manner here. So once you solve it here, this integration here, then we'll come to final conclusion. So in this function, it doesn't matter here which one you are going to pick it for the integration because both are segregable here. Okay. But out of the two functions here, you can pick any one here, but you should be careful in the limits here if there is a dependency here. Okay, if the function which is depending on x and y are interlinked here, but here you can segregate it here. X and y integration here, it doesn't matter which one you pick first or which one you pick later here. Okay. So once we, yes, because the function is independent, nah? So it doesn't matter if I go for x here, so x limits are different. I am substituting the values here, it is coming constant. If I go with the y here, you can, But you should be careful with the limit here. Don't mix the limit values here. X with y and y with x here. Okay. But if you mix up with the limits here, then you'll get the wrong answer here. Otherwise, it is an independent here, segregable function here. So out of the two, you could pick anyone and move ahead here. It doesn't matter. So this was the answer here. Now we could find out the covariance here among them here. So this will be EXY minus EXY EY. So as we have explored in the previous case here, covariance values here. Okay, so covariance value, what we calculate, how we get calculate here, this EXY minus EX into EY here. So covariance, we have calculated first EXY, then we calculate EX, EY. Now from here we could go for the covariance function here, this EXY minus EX into EY, just substitute the values here and it is coming as a zero here. So as the value of covariance is coming in zero, so from this result you could say here these functions are independent here. Okay, and there is another property for the independence here. If they are independent here, so in case of joint density function, if you remember we have discussed, the joint density function will be the product of the individual function, the density functions here, or individual random variable density functions here. So here, so you could verify either of them here from out of the conclusion once we calculate it, these values here. Okay, so first EXY is coming 32/9, EX is coming 4/3, EY is coming 8/3. If you take the product of these two here, it will come 32/9 here, which is just the same here. So there is no point which one I am going to pick first or which one I am going to pick later here. Okay. So however, the correlation between two random variables is zero, we cannot immediately conclude that the random variables are independent here. There are a few more properties related to the independence here. There was just one we have seen here. So in the previous case here, in case of independent, we have seen if the functions are independent here, they will be segregable here. So occurrence of one is not going to hamper the other random variables outcomes here. Okay. So there are certain properties if the functions are independent here. So as we are moving ahead with the two random variables x and y here, so if we someone asked here to verify that given the function x and y is independent or not here, so we need to check these properties here. If any of the properties is correct here, then we could conclude that the given function is independent here. Okay, so first property is what we have just seen in the previous example here, that a joint density function will be equal to the product of their individual marginal density functions here. Okay, so fxy into xy will be equal to fxx here, or you can say this marginal density function of x here into fyy, that is the marginal density function with respect to the y here. Okay, so in the similar way, if we go for the second here, second functions here, so in case of second function, we could say a property third here. Okay, that is fxy, that will be fxx here. So means, so if you see the left hand side part here, it is about the conditional density function. Okay, so this conditional density function properties, so this part is left hand side here, left hand side here, right hand side here. So if you see the left hand side part here, this is the conditional density functions here. If you see the right hand side part here, this is the marginal density functions here. Could you pick up here why I'm saying? Because if you see the nature of this function here, this is y slash x here, this is x slash y here. So means this is a density function of y with respect to the given x. In case of 2, in case of 3, let's say the density function of x with respect to the given y here, and this will be equal to fx x here. So for l all x and y with fy is greater than 0 and with fx is greater than 0 here, respectively, in case of the random variable x and y here. It is part is clear here, what is the property we have discussed. And similarly, if we go with the distribution function here, in case of distribution function level here, we would say that the joint probability distribution of x and y will be equal to the product of this is the joint probabilities here, so it should be clear here, this is joint probability of x and y here, and this joint probability will be equal to the probability here corresponding to the random variable x and the random variable y here, or any sets and be in the range of x and y here, it doesn't matter here. So this could be true for either of them here. Okay, so is this clear to all of you here, or any doubt here regarding any properties here? Okay. Okay, many people are saying clear, sir, clear, 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 then, okay. So it's all clear or complete clear here? So when they say it is clear, it is, has come with the ambiguity here. Okay. So what is the source level here? So here we could predict it here, what you have learned. So when you're saying this is a clear sir here, so based on that, there could be two kinds of clear here with the ambiguity. One clear corresponding to you got what I was trying to communicate here. And second, you didn't get anything what I was trying to communicate here. So both will come with the same outcome here. Yes, that's very nice. Correct here. From the Dipanshu here, we need time to practice to get handle. Good. Because these concepts are interesting here, as well as they are highly interlinked with each other here in terms of the relation, as well as their formulas, their characteristic here. Yeah, but if you go through the book here, solve some problem here, then you will have the very crystal clarity here what we are trying to communicate here and what you are trying to explain here. Okay, so this clarity should be with you at your level here when you are trying to answer here. Okay. So as you will have no doubt here, so let's move ahead here and go for a few more things. So general function of random variables here. Okay, so till now in our discussion here, we have explored about the random variables here, which was directly here linked here. So correspondingly, so you can say some random experiments outcome here, we have directly linked the two random variable x and y here. Okay, for example, if you can define one event here, this tossing a coin here outcome is coming head and tail here, so this could be x here. Similar manner, I could define another random variable here y here, that would be related to the outcome of rolling a dice here, where outcome could be x is y is equal to 1 2 3 4 5 6 here. Okay, so this way we could differentiate it here. But now we are moving slightly ahead of that here in case of general function of random variable here. So that direct relation between the function is not here. Okay. So now the experiment outcome here. Okay. So based on the experiment outcome here, I am going to define a function here. And then based on that function, I am going to define a random variables here. Okay. So there's two. Still the mapping is 1-to-1 here. So based on the random variables here, experiment outcome here, I have defined here random variables here, and on top of that random variable, I'm defining another random variables here. Okay, this is general function here. So now previous cases here, if you remember what we are writing, f x here, fx x here, that was our standard representation here what we discussed till this stage here to denote the density functions here. Okay, now we are moving slightly ahead here. So now that x, what we are taking here, that x is not a straightforward x here, that x is u y here. Okay, so on this x here we have defined a function that is working as u y here. Then on top of that function we have defining here the density functions here. So again, in principle it's same here with a slight change here in the formulas here. So you can think of here, it is not coming straightforward on the experiment's outcome here, but we are defining some function on the experiment outcome here, and then on top of it we are defining the our desired density functions here. Okay, so this way you could be here. So here, suppose that x is a discrete random variable with probability distribution fxx here. Let y is equal to hx, define a one-to-one transformation between the value of x and y here. So still you need to remember here that the in case of random variable, the thumb rule which you have defined here, there will be one-to-one transformation here. Okay, so okay, so the point is when you're going for this one-to-one mapping here, then this mapping is going to be preserved here. Okay, it is not going to change. Okay, the mapping is still one-to-one transformation what we have discussed in case of our earlier discussion here. So that mapping is still unchanged here. Okay, now we are just define another intermediate function here, based on that we are moving here. So here y is equal to hx, define a one-to-one transformation between the values of x and y, so that the equation y is equal to hx can be solved uniquely for x in terms of, so that's the important term here. There's two things, one-to-one transformation happening earlier, then solved uniquely for x in terms of y here. Let the solution be x is equal to uy here, then the probability mass function of the random variable y you could define it here. Okay, so there is still one-to-one transformation happening here. Here just a one intermediate steps we have involved here, and that intermediate step is in terms of one functions here. We are not dealing straightforward with the first place with the random variable here, but we are dealing with this random variable associated functions here, which we have defined on top of the random variable here. Then we are moving ahead here. Okay, so let us take one example here which we have discussed earlier in discussion here. So based on that problem here, we'll solve few more things here. Okay, I think there is a one comment came to me. Which book is good to practice problem, SOM or PBAS here? Okay, so both are the good book here. So which one will find comfortable, you can move ahead here. So but if you prefer from the number of examples here, then you can prefer the SOM series also here. But out of the two books, both are good here, so either of them you can pick here for your practice here. Okay, okay. So let us consider the previous case here. A company has company that service air conditioning units, residence and office blocks is interested in how to schedule its technician in the most efficient manner here. The random variable x, taking the values 1, 2, 3 and 4 is the service time in hours, and the random variable y, taking the values 1, 2 and 3 is the number of air conditioner units here. So for this part here, we already discussed about how we can find out their related probability mass function as well as their associated cumulative distribution functions here. So that value is already we have learned in the previous discussion here, calculated here. Now on top of this problem here, that the x and y is given to me, now we'll go for few more operations here which will what we have discussed in earlier discussion here. So if we go for the ex and ey operations here, expectation of x here, x into fx, I could calculate it here. So what is the values is given, x and fx is given here. I got x is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and subsequently their associated values here. Okay, similarly for ey, I could perform the same here and I can go ahead. Now for the exy, Now for the EXY, I could calculate it here. Okay. EXY, I could calculate the same here and just substitute it here. Okay. I'll say PIZ, I could calculate EXY value. Similarly, once we have the information about the EX, EY, and EXY here, I could go for the covariance function. Covariance is equal to EXY minus EX into EY here. Okay, so just substitute the values here, and we will get the values 0.224 here. If you remember in the previous case here, when we were discussing, we got the zero values here. So from that values, we have to find okay, that this function value is coming as a that this value is coming from the independent function because their values was equal to the zero here. But here you can see there is this values is non-zero here, means the functions are have some dependency. You can't say this is independent here. Okay, so here we have defined the covariance value xy is equal to xy. From here we calculate 0.224 here. Now we can use the variance properties also here in order to find out the covariance here. Okay. So covariance properties, the correlation here, I could find out correlation here. So variance of x and variance of y, how we could find out? If I calculate the expectation operation ex here, in case of variance, what is an x square into fx here? Okay, so expectation it is x into fx. In case of variance, it is x square into fx. In case of variance y, it will be integration y square into fx, as we are dealing with the discrete here. So integration will be replaced by the summation functions here. So just substitute the values here, you will get variance x and y here. Now to find out the correlation, just substitute the values here. Here for variance x and this variance y here, then it will come as a 0.34 here. So values between minus and 1 are independent and will have a correlation of 0 here, as we have discussed. In case of independent, this correlation will need to be 0 here. This is, as these are not independent here, so this value will be some finite in the range of minus 1 to 1 here. Okay. Now there is another things here. What if random variable x and y have a linear relationship here? So how we can move ahead? Okay. Can anyone guess here? This is very simple here. Yeah, why this coming to this part here? So this is the random variable x and y, how it is coming here. So first we are defining the relation at the random variable level here, then on top of it we are going to perform some mathematical operations here. On these mathematical operation, how this is going to behave here, we are interested to define those things here. Okay, y is equal to x plus b, you could define here. When a is not equal to 0, then covariance x and y is equal to xy minus x into ey here. Here this will be e x x plus b, because we can substitute the value. I could substitute the value of y here. Okay, once I can substitute the value of y here, then I can solve it here. Okay, because exy, so x we have taken and this y we are interested here. This y value is ex plus b, so this term again ex into y. So once we are applying this expectation operation here, we have already have understanding here. If it is a constant function here, then it could be taken out of that expectation operations here. Okay, so ex into ex plus b here, so I could take it inside also here. So a ex, a could be in, e could be in here, so a could be out, a constant. So it will be a e square x minus b expectation of x operations here. Then once you solve it here, once you solve it here, a expectation x square, this will be minus this one. But if you see these two terms, b expectation, this is minus b expectation here. So this will be, these two will be canceling each other here. So finally it will come in a x square minus e square x here, or it could be a times into variance of x here. So variance x, how we could define, how we defined here, this is e x square minus e square x here. So what is the mean value? The square of the mean here. Okay, so to define this here, once you have defined this one here, we could substitute it here and I could solve it here. So once you are going for the composite function kinds here, if the functions are not dependent here and they have some kinds of relation, linear relations here, we could also perform the similar operation here, just keeping a note of the fundamental understanding here, what we have done in the previous case here. Okay, so this previous understanding will be applicable with us here. Here, that once you go for expectation operation, you should be very clear which one is constant function, which is the variable functions here. So as expectation operation will apply on the variable only here, constant terms we could take in out here. Okay, so this is a very important point here. You should be very clear about it here. Okay, if you confuse here about these terms here, then you're never going to enter with some conclusion here. Okay, in the previous discussion, if you remember, when you're going with ex and y here, so once there is a operation, priority mean operations here, so that values will come into constant here. So we could segregate it, taken out here, out that of operation here, the previous problem here, if you remember here. So these are the few things which are related with the joint density functions here, or against the two random variables here, which we have explored here. So there is few more concepts here, which is just still left here. So we'll go for those concepts here, okay, and we'll solve it here. Any doubt regarding what we have discussed till today?
Yes, sir. I think, sir, in previous example, there is something misprint.
Here?
No, sir. One page more back. Sir, one page more. Yes, sir. Sir, in this, the value of P12 should be 0.08, no?
Yes, yes, sir. Yeah, that's why I remember here, but in the previous time we have corrected here, but here this is mistake. Correct.
And sir, in above also, the joint PMF 0.12 plus 0.08.
Yes, yes, sir. Because there is no 0.18 here, it will be 0.08 here.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Good observation here and correction. Yes. Thanks for correction here. Okay. Anything else? Any other input here? No. Okay, so did you people understand what we are trying to discuss here? So there is few more problems here during the discussion we'll pick up here, so that we'll have the clarities here. So what we are trying to conclude. Okay, let me check your chat box if there is any comment here. Okay, I think there's no. Okay, this is a very good questions here. I think one of the tough question. Sir, can you share the slides? So did you receive my previous slides here, Ankit? Yes, then you will get this one also. Need not to worry. If you have any other problem, then just let me know. Okay, I think there's no more problem here. So with this, this is all for the today here. Thank you. Thank you very much.